Hey Blog Buddies, in case you haven't heard, there is a pair of gay penguins living at the Toronto Zoo. Their names are Buddy and Pedro. Buddy's 20 years old, Pedro is 10. Wait, is that even legal? Basically, Buddy and Pedro are totally inseparable. They groom each other, they hang out, they even sleep together at night, not to mention the hot Brokeback Iceberg sex they have when no one's watching. Why can't I just quit you? Though penguins mate for life, sadly the zookeepers are splitting up the gay penguins and pairing them off with females because apparently they're endangered and they need to populate the species. I just hope that Buddy and Pedro can get it up. But the penguins aren't alone. Homosexuality, as it turns out, is actually super common and it's found in hundreds and hundreds of species. In fact, some scientists say that the only species it hasn't been observed in are sea urchins and aphids. And tell me, who the fuck wants to have sex with a sea urchin? Not me, or an aphid, let's be real. So check it out, for bonobos, 60% of the sexual activity is between females. With giraffes, gay sex is more common than straight sex. And a quarter of all black swan pairings are totally gay, and I am not just talking Natalie Portman and Mila Kunis. Anyway, here's what I'm getting at. You don't see the straight penguins picketing the gay penguins with little God hates fag penguin signs. They're just kind of unfazed by the whole thing. Homosexuality is found in hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of different species all around the world. Homophobia, on the other hand, is exclusive to us humans. So considering all of that, tell me which of the two is more unnatural. Booyah! By the way, do you know what they call a gay dinosaur? A Megasaurus.